You observe Surya Namaskar, it is a discipline. You wake up early in the morning, it is a discipline to keep your body healthy, you to keep your mind peaceful. There are certain things. In social life, obey the rules of the road, government, etc. In the house, in the domestic life, follow the husband, obey the orders of the husband. Problem comes. Observe the dictates given by your elder brother, still more problematic. Whatever your principle says, carry it out. No. Life principles, natural principles, to some extent we agree, but in the life, real life, we try to revolt. No. That is where Hinduism stands foremost. We have three beautiful books. One is the Ramayana. The other is the Mahabharata. Third is Bhagavata. In the Ramayana, you have four brothers. Sri Ram, Bharat, Lakshman and Shatrughna. And in the Mahabharata, Pandavas are five in number. Yudhishthir, Bhim, Arjun, Nakul and Sahadev. And in Bhagavata, you have two Yadava brothers, Balaram and Krishna. The discipline is followed by all the three teams. In the Ramayana, Rama is the eldest brother. The rule of life says, obedient to the elder brother. Show me a single example where Lakshmana is disobedient to Ram, Bharata is disobedient to Ram, Shatrughna is disobedient to Ram. Everywhere they applied their minds, they submitted themselves, they willingly allowed themselves to be ordered by Sri Ram. Whatever Rama said was in toto followed by Bharata, Lakshmana and Shatrughna. Lakshmana was not very happy when Rama was driven to the forest. As a matter of fact, he drew this sword. He was ready to kill everybody who was responsible for the exile of Sri Ram. But Ram said, no, keep quiet. And immediately Lakshmana submitted. Bharata was not willing to send Rama to the forest. He tried to bring him back to the capital. Rama said no. He was obedient. And Shatrughna always, of course. In the team Sri Ram, Lakshman, Bharat, Shatrughna, you find the eldest brother's orders followed. There is strict obedience to the instructions of Sri Ram. Then audience would say, sir, Rama is great. Rama is the tallest, Rama is the best, Rama is the strongest, Rama is the most intelligent, Rama is the most understanding person, Rama is all skillful, therefore such a great person, it is an opportunity to be obedient to him, it is a blessing to be obedient to him. Such husband if I have, I too will be obedient. Such principle if we have, we too will be obedient. Such elder brother if we have, we too will be obedient. But sir, my elder brother is an idiot. My husband is a fool. My principal is a rascal. How can I obey him? He does not know, sir. He has no intelligence, sir. He has no brains, sir. How can you compare him with Sri Ramachandra Prabhu? Rama is great. Come to Mahabharata. Yudhishthir is senior among the brothers only in age and in the understanding of dharma. Bhima is stronger than Yudhishthir, more skillful than Yudhishthir, more powerful than Yudhishthir, but Bhima was obedient to Yudhishthir. Arjuna was much more skillful than Yudhishthir. Arjuna was more handsome than Yudhishthira. He was the person to attract the looks of Draupadi. Draupadi fell in love with Arjuna. She wanted to marry him, not the others. But still, Arjuna was obedient to the instructions of Yudhishthira. Nakula, so wonderfully a gentleman he was capable of riding his horse without a single drop of rain falling on him or the horse. So skillfully he would drive the horse. Such Nakul was obedient to Yudhishthira. Sahadeva was supposed to be the greatest devotee and an excellent astrologer. In spite of his abilities, in spite of his wisdom, he was obedient to Yudhishthira. If Lakshmana, Bharata, Shatrughna were obedient to Rama, there was no wonder, because Rama is the best, supreme, sublime, excellent, wonderful, powerful, etc. But in the case of Mahabharata brothers, Yudhishthira is senior to them only in age and in the understanding of Dharma. Otherwise, all the four brothers are superior to him. Still, they were all obedient and disciplined. Come to Bhagavat. You find these two wonderful brothers, Balaram and Krishna. Balaram is senior to Krishna only in age. In intelligence? No. In skill? No. In wisdom? No. In no other field, Balaram is superior to Krishna except in age. Balaram was born a little earlier than Sri Krishna, that's all. Krishna is more intelligent. Krishna is more handsome. Krishna is more knowledgeable. Krishna is more wise. Krishna is all-powerful. Still, Sri Krishna never disobeyed Balaram. You read the entire Mahabharata, or even the Mahabharata, where you find the stories of these two people. He was very, very obedient to his Balaram. Elder brother, yes, boss. Are we doing it? Then the question would be, no, sir, my boss is a rascal. My husband is a fool idiot. If we follow him, the family will be in ruins, sir. The college will go to dark, sir. No, nothing would happen. When I say my husband is a fool, that means you are more intelligent. When I say my boss is an idiot, that means I am more intelligent. When I say my elder brother is a useless fellow, I am more intelligent. Your intelligence must be shown in your obedience and getting your things done through his mouth. If you are very intelligent. Sri Krishna is very intelligent. All the decisions of Balaram were not always correct. There were many mistakes, but Krishna never disobeyed. He corrected Balarama without appearing to be correcting him. That is your intelligence. Example. Balaram one day called Krishna. My brother? Yes, boss. I have decided to get my sister Subhadra married to Duryodhana. Yes, sir. Duryodhana is a wonderful king. Yes, sir. Subhadra is a beautiful young daughter of our parents and she is our sister. She deserves to marry Duryodhana. Yes, sir. For everything Krishna said, yes, 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 yes. Never contradicted. And Subhadra was listening to the conversation of Balaram and Krishna through the window. Krishna said, yes. You send the invitations to Duryodhana. Yes. For everything Krishna said yes. When Krishna was coming out, Subhadra went to Krishna. Chinnanna, elder brother has decided to give me in marriage to Duryodhana. I don't like that fellow. I don't want to marry him. Krishna says, what can I do? The boss has decided. I cannot. No, 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 no. If you can, if you will, you can do it. Then Krishna beautifully played. Next day he went to Balaram. Anna, Yes. There is a great sage, a great sannyasi, a great saint passing through Dwaraka. What? When a sage is going through Dwaraka, you come and make a simple report of that, go and invite him. Yes, sir. Next day he came. Sir, my dear brother, I invited that sage. I got his accommodation in the circuit house, in the traveler's bungalow, in the 5-star hotel. What nonsense you are speaking, my younger brother Krishna. When sages, saints, rishis, sadhus, sannyasis come, they must come to the palace. They must be the guests of the king. You please bring him here. Anna, all the sadhus are not good. All the sannyasis are not pure. You are asking him to be brought. Shall I bring? Yes, I say you bring him. Yes, boss. He brought him. My dear elder brother, I have appointed many servant girls to take care of this age. What nonsense you are speaking. Our sister Subhadra is present. She is a virgin. She is a kanya. When great Durvasa Maharshi came, Brihma Maharshi came, our family is such, the unmarried girls in the house were asked to serve the sages and get their boons. Why did you appoint the servant girls? Ask Subhadra to go and serve that sage. Anna, Subhadra is very innocent, very young, very tender. That sadhu is not nothing doing. Do as I say. Yes, sir. He did everything as dictated by the elder brother. What is the result? Subhadra and Arjuna ran away. They got married. What I am trying to drive home here is, never contradict. At one point of time, Draupadi asks Krishna, why did you come and save me when my robes were being removed? You called me again. I saved you, I protected you. But why did you come late? Why did you not give the saris immediately? Why did you not protect me immediately? Then Krishna says, you were less obedient to your husband. You suspected his dharmic nature. You asked a question, is Dharmaraj right in losing me after losing his everything? You should have absolute faith, absolute dedication to the cause. When we have that obedient attitude to the rules of the road, to the social life, to the elders, to the gurus, to the masters, we are sure to succeed. Sri Krishna never disobeyed the instructions of the elders. He is certainly more intelligent. He got his intelligent views expressed by his elders and he obeyed. Sri Krishna is an adarsha purusha. He is a great jnana yogi. He is himself a great bhakta. There was not even a single day when Sri Krishna did not perform Surya Namaskars. There is not a single day on which Sri Krishna did not practice yogas. He is an exemplary model, an excellent character. He has followed that discipline and therefore he is a karma yogi. Sri Krishna never preached without practicing. He became a yogi and then he practiced yogic life to everybody. Let's meditate on Sri Krishna and let us try to observe the discipline.
Shanti, Shanti.